In today's video, we're going to explain everything we know about how to naturally raise your testosterone levels through exercise. We'll cover how testosterone is produced in the body, how intense your workouts should be, the kinds of exercises to focus on, and the best order in which to do them, whether it's resistance training or endurance work. Finally, we'll look at the lasting effects of exercise on testosterone, as well as factors that could limit your ability to naturally increase testosterone. How does the body produce testosterone? In men, around 95% of testosterone is made in the testicles by specialized cells called Leydig cells. The brain plays a crucial role in starting this process. It begins in the hypothalamus, which releases a hormone known as gonadotropin, releasing hormone. This hormone tells the pituitary gland to release another hormone, luteinizing hormone LH, which signals the Leydig cells in the testicles to produce testosterone. Once made, testosterone is sent throughout the body, including to the muscles. Inside muscle cells, testosterone binds to androgen receptors, triggering a chain of events that leads to gene expression and the creation of proteins and building blocks for the body. How does exercise increase testosterone levels? Exercise triggers the release of both catabolic and anabolic hormones, with testosterone being one of the anabolic hormones. This surge in testosterone helps increase the activity of androgen receptors, leading to greater protein synthesis. After exercising, testosterone levels temporarily spike, which lengthens the half-life of androgen receptor mRNA, making muscle growth hypertrophy more likely. But there's a catch. You need to hit a certain threshold of workout intensity or volume to see a significant testosterone boost. Now let's dive into the workout details. Intensity, sets, repetitions, workout order, and rest periods. Resistance training. It has been well studied when it comes to testosterone production. Intensity refers to the difficulty of the exercise, typically gauged by the amount of weight lifted. Repetition maximum is the most weight you can lift for a given number of reps, and volume refers to the total amount of work, which includes sets, repetitions, and intensity. For example, if you lift 100 pounds for 5 reps, then increase the weight to 150 pounds for 5 reps, you've increased intensity. If you keep the weight at 100 pounds but do 10 reps instead, you've increased volume. Higher volume is a key factor in boosting testosterone. Best exercises for boosting testosterone. Studies have shown that high-intensity, lower body exercises performed with close to your 100% repetition maximum, the maximum weight you can lift, are particularly effective for boosting testosterone. For example, doing 3 sets of 3 to 5 repetitions of lower body exercises at 100% of your 6 repetition maximum has been shown to help. On the other hand, doing 5 sets of 10 repetitions with slightly lighter weights can also increase testosterone, but you should still aim for heavy loads that challenge your body. Endurance training. Short bursts of endurance training can also raise testosterone temporarily. Workouts of 2 to 5 minutes at 90 to 100% of your VO2 max, the maximum amount of oxygen your body can use, can lead to a brief increase in testosterone. However, longer or more intense endurance training may cause a drop in testosterone due to the release of cortisol, a stress hormone that inhibits testosterone production. This is especially true for elite endurance athletes, who may even have lower testosterone levels due to the stress their body experiences during prolonged aerobic activity. Resistance versus endurance training. If your goal is to boost testosterone, resistance training is the better option. Although some studies have shown improvements in testosterone levels with high-intensity interval training, the increase is typically short-lived, lasting an hour or so post-exercise. Regular resistance training, on the other hand, has been shown to elevate testosterone for up to 48 hours after a workout. Sets, reps, and rest periods. As previously mentioned, workout volume is the most crucial factor. You can adjust your sets and reps as long as you maintain high intensity to ensure sufficient volume. A study looking at rest periods showed that shorter rest times, 60 seconds versus 90 seconds between sets, led to higher testosterone levels, so aim for less rest between sets for better results. If you find this information helpful, please like, subscribe, and turn all notifications on to stay updated with our latest fitness tips. One study divided 40 men into 3 groups. one trained to failure, one trained without reaching failure, and the third didn't train at all. Interestingly, the group that didn't train to failure saw greater improvements in leg muscle power, while the failure group showed better gains in the number of bench press repetitions. In terms of testosterone, those who didn't train to failure had lower cortisol levels and higher testosterone. So training to failure may not be ideal for increasing testosterone. Best resistance exercises. For maximum testosterone production, prioritize exercises that target large muscle groups. Movements like squats, Olympic lifts, and jump squats engage multiple muscles and lead to higher testosterone increases. Free weights are better than machines, as they also recruit stabilizing muscles like the core, which contributes to a larger testosterone boost. Should you combine resistance and endurance training? If you plan to combine both resistance and endurance exercises, start with resistance training. Working your larger muscle groups first will help keep your testosterone elevated throughout the entire workout. Long-term changes in testosterone levels. Will resistance training permanently increase your baseline testosterone levels? The data is mixed. While regular exercise has been shown to elevate testosterone temporarily, it may not have a lasting effect on resting levels in the general population. However, some small studies suggest that older adults and obese individuals might see an increase in their baseline testosterone after regular resistance training, possibly due to weight and fat loss. Factors that can limit testosterone boosts. If you're doing everything right but still struggling to boost testosterone, certain factors could be holding you back. Obesity can impair blood flow to the testicles, which may limit the testosterone response. Additionally, testosterone production declines by 1-3% annually after the age of 40. While older men and those with higher body fat still produce testosterone after exercise, the response is often less than in younger, leaner individuals. No matter your age, weight, or fitness level, regular resistance training, especially with large muscle groups, moderate to high intensity, short rest periods, and high volume, can help increase testosterone levels. So get moving and start with some jump squats right at home to give your testosterone a natural boost. Thank you for watching. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. If you found this information helpful, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more tips and insights on health and fitness, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.